Queen here, another episode of Queen Rex, and today we are getting to Rainbow Dash Presents. What the fuck is with the voice cracking? Rainbow Dash Presents. Yeah, this is episode... I don't even know what number this is. Hold on, let me just find it. I don't know, it doesn't say. But it does say, Presents Captain Hook, the Biker Gorilla. Yeah, no idea what this story is. I've never heard of this. Unlike some of the other ones, because some of them I have known, like Cupcakes, obviously. I was vaguely familiar with Bubbles, I think he did that, but I'm not really sure on this one. So, yeah. Apparently there's going to be something pirate themed, I'm guessing, and I guess you got Captain Hook, so maybe they're going to go Peter Pan on us. And then you got a biker gorilla, so I think this series has some sort of thing with gorillas, and that anytime there's a human involved, they're replaced with a gorilla. Is that the case? Not sure, but oh well. We're just gonna get right into this. In 3, 2, 1.
Hey, Chump. I hear you need some inane favor.
Oh, yeah. Twilight, could you please hack Trixie Variety Show for me?
Right.
Do what now?
It's a website where they show videos that Trixie likes, and a lot of ponies go there. I want ponies to see my videos, so please hack them.
Okay. There are a number of problems with your brilliant plan, and
yeah.
One of them is that I don't know how to hack computers.
I thought you knew Linux.
I don't.
It's okay. I bought a book. You can read it and use your brain to learn how.
Another problem is that I don't care.
Man.
Wow.
Friggin' Trixie Variety Show keeps putting my videos into footnote updates, which they call roundups, and sometimes that's only after I pester them. One of them told me in an email that he thought my videos were just boring, played-out stories that nobody wants to hear again.
Well, it sounds like they don't care either, so the circle is complete.
Wow.
I mean, I've got my own songs, a lengthy script with over 250 lines of dialogue, several voice actors, and the entire thing is hand-drawn and edited frame by over 1,000 frames. Seriously, I have more than 1,000 pictures in this folder, but they said they're not gonna touch it!
Well, if they let everyone get by on that amount of effort, I imagine they'd be buried in thousands of submissions doing the exact same thing. They've gotta set standards.
Some guy named Al Capone's made it to the media page by doing a half-assed one-minute voiceover of a scene from Peter Pan, and then another user made it to the
there's
media
a,
page
by
adding
Peter Pan.
A course of Space Jam to that.
Why do you want on this website again?
I need to be loved.
Okay, look.
Wow.
It's obvious that the video submissions are run fairly unprofessionally, so if anything, your videos are just being bounced or shuffled aside because the guys in charge have a prejudice against whatever it is you're reading.
Wow.
Since they're probably not really watching the video to verify quality, I figure you should just change the title to something else.
Would I get in trouble for that?
I don't know.
CMC there. So, what was the original?
Captain Hook the Biker Gorilla.
Oh, okay. Oh, it was Captain Hook the Biker.
Rainbow Factory.
Oh, okay, I see.
Also, check out my new fireplace.
So this is going to be Rainbow Factory, and yes, it's a nice fireplace. Just Sweetie Belle's in the mood right now.
Here. Yeah, I know,
yeah.
It's a long video.
It's about 26 minutes, I think.
It's a bright springtime day in Cloudsdale. The weather is predictably perfect, and the reason is because today is the day of the Pegasus exams for all the little fillies and colts. Scootaloo, you've just turned old enough to take your test. You woke up feeling a little nervous, but after barfing once, you feel a lot better. That's gross.
Yeah.
Apple Bloom and Sweetie Belle are here for moral support. They decided to come along after seeing how worried you were, so they're tied to your tail and some balloons so they won't fall down.
The string is chafing me. That is normal.
Now don't worry, baby. I know just the thing to soothe those rubbing birds.
Okay, A, I don't know if that plan
so
is that plan's
gonna
work.
You sign a couple waivers, and then you wait in line. Standing next to you
glazed,
is a little cold.
Hey there, handsome. I like your hair. Does the carpet match the drapes?
I don't know.
Mine does.
I'm Orion. Orion Comet. You can call me OC for short.
I'm Hoop Scootaloo.
Wow.
And these are my friends,
Orion
Apple Bloom
Comet.
And Thracker's Odd.
I am a regular.
What, second, what is that voice?
I like your wings.
I've never seen an Earth Pony in Cloudsdale before. Are they taking the exam?
No, they're just here to watch my ass. Hoo-ah!
There's like some kind of instructor there named Miss Blossomforth. She looks a lot like Cherilee, except with wings, and she's totally different colors.
She's green.
Stop your chattiness. We have work today. I have a test to administer, and it will not be postponed. Now continue to stand in a disorganized line. I will call your names in alphabetical order, so... You! Are you chewing gum? spit it out. Now, Terpy. I will call your names, and our judges will determine if you have passed the exam. However, I must warn you, there are many ways to fail. If you fly too far west, you will fail. If you drop below the cloud layer, you will fail. If you perform the exam in reverse, you will fail.
What if we opt? Hadn't taken the test.
The exam.
Wait, continue to fly.
And upon that exam,
in this,
you will fail.
What if we finish too fast?
Then you will fail.
And what if we pass?
Then you exit the educational system. And that is a world an educator is frowned upon to understand. I know not what will happen.
So we don't have to go to school anymore?
I assume yes. Though I dare not contemplate the consequences.
Sweet. I want that one.
You guys all get ready, and Miss Blossomforth calls out some names. The first one is some little filly named Aurora.
I heard she has pony aids.
You there? Do not talk during the exam.
Aurora starts with the test, pony but pretty much right away she breaks one wing, dislocates the other, and chips 4 teeth. She does all of this during freefall, which I'm pretty sure was impossible beforehand.
Somebody must help that pony.
I do not think that pony can be helped.
Are you passing notes?
I ship it.
If you are caught passing notes during the exam, then you are failed.
Room, are you eating paper?
That had to do with the exam.
This is an educational system, and the system does not have time to differentiate between good and bad note passing. Go to the gates of shame with Aurora. No!
I guess he's not passing anything that has to do with the exam. OC goes to the gates of shame. And your name comes up next, Scootaloo.
Here, hold these guys. Hold them tight.
Wait, I have an idea. What if we help you with your exam?
Oh, that's brilliant, baby, but I'm not sure I can seduce Miss Blossomforth well enough for the judges to allow it, sugar pie.
The rules say no Pegasus may receive assistance from another Pegasus, or a bizarro Pegasus. The system does not have time to understand its own intent. So, you are permitted to receive help from your friends. However, if they turn out to be secret Pegasi, then you will be failed.
All right, let's show the superiority of a threesome.
Hoo-ah! We're gonna ace this test.
The words are stupid, but I must agree with the group.
Well, the entire test is just a physical exam, so with two other ponies tied to you, you basically bomb the time cloud kicking exercise, Apple Bloom gets tangled up in the hoops during the agility section, and the extra weight causes you to fall right through the cloud floor during the free fall portion.
I kind of feel like that's gonna happen.
Kinda fail you with a vengeance.
Oh wait, I want a do-over. I had an unfair handicap and then I had two fillies riding me the whole time.
The educational system does not have time to understand the difference between a normal, unencumbered pony and a pony that has other ponies tied to her. If this exam were fair, it would take all day. Now, go to the gates of shame.
No amount of logic or reasoning can persuade the educational system, you guys. You've got no other choice but to go to the gates of shame with Aurora and Orion.
No, I want to go with the other ponies. There are more of them.
Waiting for you there is pretty much the creepiest pony you've ever seen. It looks like somebody cooked bacon in his hair this morning. He's got the kind of facial scruff you'd use to scrape crud off of dishes that you've left out for, like, a month. He's got a beat-up old van with no engine in it, and you can only assume he pulls it himself from elementary school to elementary school on the weekdays.
I will not stand for this kind of humiliation!
Nobody is humiliating you!
Yeah, you're not being humiliated, Orion.
It's true. Now you sound like an idiot.
Well, now I'm being humiliated, and I will not stand for this kind of humiliation!
My name is Dazzler, and this is my cat! He pays the bills, but I have rights too! Get in my van!
My wing is broken. I really, really bad.
Okay, get in the van!
I was sorta hoping for some medical attention.
Nine!
I will not stand for this maltreatment.
Fine, get in the van. The cat is a doctor.
Get to the chopper.
How do you think he pays the rent?
Aurora climbs in the van and the cat follows afterward.
Actually, that's why I came out German.
Dazzler comes in the van and pulls some clipboards and stuff.
Here, fill out this medical paperwork and be sure to list any pre-existing conditions or medication allergies. Please hand me your insurance information when you return the forms.
She has pony aids.
You guys fill out the confusing paperwork as best you can, and after a while, the cat comes out, and Dazzler ushers you into the back of the van. The entire process uses kind of a lot of unnecessary physical contact. The inside of the van smells like burnt cheese and mouthwash, and the only thing in there is like a billion Parasprite cans. It looks like Aurora's all better though, or at least in one piece. That cat is a freaking miracle worker, granted a complete lack of medical equipment. The van starts moving. Where you're going, you have no idea, but you get the feeling it's gonna be kind of a long trip.
So...
I hear you have pony aids. Do any of the rest of us have pony aids?
Wherever Dazzler is taking you, his route is totally indirect. He's driving Cloudsdale. He
this
stops
is
to drive through at the bank.
Just because the cat pays the rent doesn't mean I don't have rights! And I would like to deposit a check! The cat can't stop me!
He goes to a drive-thru at McSoy's.
McSoy's?
I would like a double happy!
Sir, you could have a double happy. Get the hell out of my drive-thru!
He drops you off at the hardware store and leaves you there for like an hour. When he comes back, he smells like fish. Basically, he takes you all over town, then he finally drives you guys to the weather factory in Cloudsdale.
Fish.
The stallions approach the van. They're wearing gym clothes and Mexican wrestling masks to hide their mysterious identity.
Wait. Hey, Dazzler.
There's nothing hey about it!
So, these kids, they're from the actual exam this time, right?
The only thing I hate more than children! It's children on skateboards!
Okay. Come on, kids. Let's let Dazzler get back to the grown-up stuff. We've got a lot of work today.
You guys pile out of the van and follow the two masked ponies inside the weather building. In the reception room, a white pony in a bright purple suit is there waiting.
Hey, kids, welcome to the Rainbow Factory!
Oh, and
it's like Willy Wonka in here!
Yeah,
great one feels a dream minute!
It's the original Pinkie Pie. I forget the name.
Punishment for failing our exam is we have to take a tour of the Rainbow Factory with a crazy pony.
Wait, which one of us is the fat kid, baby? I call not it.
I want to be an Oompa Loompa! Take me to them so the deed may be done.
Nose goes is the fat kid.
Ow! I don't even like chocolate!
Too bad, Betty!
I'm morally outraged with this fat kid thing!
Wow.
And in love with Scootaloo! What? Cut me some slack! She looks like my mom, okay?
See? We're all having fun! You don't need to run away through the cloud floor or through the walls or anything! You're not gonna be ground up into rainbows! And that's a silly thing to think was gonna happen, you know? I don't even know, but like...
Don't miss the Yorley, they are going to grind us into rainbows!
Okay, now that's morally
what happened in the bath there?
Somebody is with me, aren't they? I'm starting to get a little frustrated over here.
Cut it out, you two. She just said we weren't gonna be grinded up into rainbows.
Yeah, that's kinda rude, Orion.
You're the fat kid.
Wow.
You're such a jerk.
That was just low, baby. It's okay, Aurora. You ain't fat.
No.
Is this in the actual Rainbow Factory? Because I've never heard of this part.
Okay, kids, the time for ridicule is over. I've got a super fun thing for you. It's a waiver form. It's like a maze or connect the dots, except with a signature. You just write your little names here, and then we're gonna go on a magical tour.
Wait, doesn't Willy Wonka kill all of the children?
Okay, hey, that's a good point. I'm not Willy Wonka no more. I ain't Pogo the Clown. See, you can trust Pogo.
No, please go back. Please go back.
I declare that this cannot go wrong.
I'd rather be killed.
Well, if Thrakorzad trusts the situation, then so do I.
So you guys sign your waivers and follow Pogo the Clown on a tour of the factory, which ends in a gigantic room made out of fluffy clouds. There's like 100 other kids here, too. Most of them have the sniffles or broken wings. There's like one kid who's got a magical glandular problem and his butt's like falling through the floor. He'd make a pretty terrible weather pony. There's also a big machine in here, and it looks like about 6 ponies in Mexican wrestler masks and sweat clothes are watching it. There's cookies and punch by the doors. Pogo flies off. She says she's gotta go talk to her boss, and that there's cookies and punch by the doors.
What is the machine for?
Nothing.
So, Orion, you love you some Scootaloo, do you?
Love isn't the right word.
Well, baby, the sky is just like a big ocean, and I'm your little love anemone.
I thought sea anemones reproduced asexually.
Not this sea anemone, my hunk-delicious manatee.
It's just what my mom would say. I don't try to understand the fillies in my life.
Alright, this guy.
Enjoy their company.
My mom!
Also, it's throwing me off because all the voices are opposites. But.
Y'all should be a tuna because they're the chickens of the sea.
Suddenly, everyone goes quiet and their attention turns to the most awesome supervisor in the world
who has just
stepped
off
the balcony above you. She's got her mask on backwards again, but she was in a hurry because she was late, so, you know. But you can just tell that she's probably, like, the fastest supervisor in Equestria. She can't breathe or anything, so she takes off her mask so she can turn it around, and oh my gosh, it's Rainbow Dash!
Yeah.
She's so awesome!
Hi, Rainbow Dash!
Yeah, hey guys, how's it going?
Awesome.
We're okay, baby, how are you? Wanna meet my new boyfriend?
Oh, sure, yeah, I'll come right down.
Hey, boss, aren't we supposed to, you know?
Yeah.
Murder children?
I was thinking that, maybe, you know, I'm really tired today, and the kids just got here, and, I mean, we got cookies and punch over there, and I brought my stereo, so I was just thinking that, instead of doing the things that we normally do, maybe,
We can have a pizza party.
Okay, first thing, we can't afford that many pizzas. Second thing, the only reason we afford anything at all is because somebody is paying us to do a job.
Well, it's a sucky job. Hey, Rainbow Dash. Hey, Apple Bloom.
Rainbow Dash.
You're wearing a wrestler mask. Oh, well, it's the dress code that we have to wear a mask, because, you know, this whole factory thing is totally like a secret conspiracy. Except morale was really low, because all we did was secretly grind ponies into other rainbows. So I thought it would really help everyone out to do, like, Crazy Time Mondays and Casual Fridays. They still have to wear the mask, but the wrestler mask are individual, so everyone gets to feel like they're recognized and important.
That's really nice.
Yep, I've only been working here for 3 days, but I'm like the best supervisor.
What was that part about the rainbows and the grinding again?
Oh. Man, you weren't supposed to tell them! They don't call it a conspiracy because you announced it to a room of 100 children! Now I dressed up like Willy Wonka and a clown for nothing!
Yeah. See? Outrage! Totally justified!
We're going to be grounded up into rainbows!
No, there's punching cookies by the door. No rainbows, pizza party!
You've been grinding up ponies, baby? You sure you don't mean grinding up on ponies?
No, I haven't done any grinding. On the first day, I locked myself in the bathroom, and I was all like, No, the bathroom is occupied. You can't come in. I'm not going. You can't make me go out there. You didn't tell me that there's gonna be little children. Not going out there.
And they had to break down the door and drag me out of there. Wow. They sent me home after. On the second day, they had to keep me, so they didn't break anything down. And today is the third day, and we've earned a break, and we should have a pizza party. There's cookies and punch by the door.
Well, what's the point?
Okay, there's a really good reason for this, and I can totally explain. Maybe over some pizza?
No.
There's no good reason for us to be ground into rainbows.
I am a normal pony, and as such, I desire a normal explanation in detail of the ritual sacrifice of children.
How come in these
me? You're the one who told them in the first place. Yeah,
fan,
okay,
in these fan series, Sweetie Belle's always the one that they make weird. It's like either a robot or a super deep voice or something. Well, this is nice.
You will be turned into rainbows, everyone will be so happy. You'll be gone, but that's okay though. Hey, cheer up, it's not that crappy. If you assume it, your life
is that first song in this series?
A rainbow, you dare not be disappointed once I stuff you into this hole. This is where we take your taxes, where we make the weather wanted. We're not chemists, so don't ask us how this method got so wanted. This job does not need a degree, that is how they got stuck with me. I need this for healthcare, you see, so I can afford therapy.
Wow. I like this animation right here.
There is a good reason, but that don't tell them nothing.
What do you mean? I need the friggin' health benefits.
That's it? What about the history?
The history is that I can't go back to 11:25 an hour because I eat too much fast food and it's really hard to pay my bills. Okay, I'll admit that they usually say you should do it for the love of the job and not for the money, but the economy is really rough right now and this was the best I could get.
You know what? Forget you. I'm gonna explain it Lucino style. Listen up, kids. Let's go back. Years ago, everything you know is owned by Celestia, the tiny blade of grass that fed on the sun, the
but
tiny grass
changed
the fed on the grass, the snake in the grass that fed on the grasshopper, the holy evil government owned by Celestia. All things trod beneath an iron roof, united, divided by Celestia, all hailed humbly to the mighty god, until one day, then came the war.
Okay.
Nightmare moves, sweat from the sky, lasers from her eyes, and teeth like knives. The power of our god was simply not enough to overcome her sister. The war had sacrificed a piece of her mind to the dark gods for deeds unkind. Hope seemed lost until the time that Celestia developed a plan. Each one power to retain the rest. Sacrifice in turn was the gist. Is so many, what was one? This foul war must be done. It must be something she could do without. A superfluous power that she could leave out. She pervaded them all, made her decision. She rested her choice, her prismatic precision. No more rainbows was her decree. Equestrious ponies would pay this fee. But petty politics on another route. The electorate could not do without. So the duty failed to the Pegasi. And when they found a solution, they began to cry. Oh, no! I'm Mr. Keller, and that is the truth. But our pleas for reprieve fell upon deaf ears, and the exit poll showed our greatest fears. We must make rainbows, there wasn't a choice. The boneheads and butt ponies smothered our voice.
It's a pretty dark story, but...
So?
It's kind of interesting when it's put in this way.
A machine.
Welcome, my son, to the machine.
Your plans are interesting, but I think they may be improved upon. For example, perhaps we might inscribe certain words on the machine when the children are sacrificed.
Ah, see? What a great kid. She's so helpful. We should throw a pizza party.
No, if we don't do this now, it's going to be us on that thing. Bring one of those kids up.
Oh, I don't know. Maybe we should sing another song.
We don't have time for another song. We'll sing tomorrow. Now just hurry up and do what's got to be done.
Okay. Okay. Ryan, now... you just sit here, alright?
Come on!
Okay. So we discovered that, for whatever reason, the rainbow process works better if you're holding a puppy. So, here's a puppy. I named him Mr. Schnuffles because of the way he tickles my neck. And also, it works better if you hold a picture of your family. So, here's a nice picture we got of your parents, wishing you good luck on the exam. And also... it works better if you have a box of crayons so you can color when you go to pony heaven.
Man, get over it. After a few of these, it's like nothing. Sure, you stay up late at night thinking about how your family would think of you, and you wonder what pony hell is gonna be like, but other than that, it's no big deal.
No!
Come on, man!
Wait! I'm not ready!
I think maybe we should escape.
That pony is going to be sacrificed. Oh, I'm going to utter a prayer so hard. I mean, yes, we should escape.
How are we gonna escape? My wing is broken so I can't fly.
She makes a good point, baby. We're surrounded by an impenetrable prison of fluffy clouds, and the 100 of us unrestrained children are being guarded by no less than 6 colorful winged ponies. Truly nothing could be more terrifying.
We need to devise an extraordinary plan.
No, I am sure a regular plan will be just fine.
Maybe we can tell everyone to follow the sequence from the exam from earlier, and each sequence will be a code from a particular kind of attack.
Oh, I'm sorry. You mean the exam that everyone in this room was too mentally deficient to pass?
We need to think of a distraction.
Hey, everyone! Look, it's Scootaloo Dance!
We need to think of a distraction that doesn't draw attention to us.
Oh my god! They're going to grind us into rainbows! Everybody panic!
Oh my gosh.
Well, I guess that works.
We don't have to get violent. We can still have a pizza party. There's pungent cookies by the door.
Good work, Aurora.
Now everyone run! It's locked! They made the clouds! What do we do?
And it goes through the clouds.
Did y'all just come from over there?
Yes. I have traversed the plane of the Rainbow Factory.
Wait. Tell us how to boogie on out of here, baby.
Very well. You can start by running up the stairs to the crypt, grab the book from the skeletons, and pass into the pit of the pendulum. Knock over the column, and climb into the king's storeroom. Smash the clay pots to find the key to lead you into the chamber of the secret markers. Match the symbols on the right to those on the left, and pass into the room of the ancient warriors. Place yourself in the correct armor, and open the door to the shrine of the silver monkey. Assemble the statue, and you may be headed to the room of the secret password. Find the tablet with the correct inscription, and shout it to open the door to the Pharaoh's secret passage. Slide down the tunnel to the quicksand bog, where you could smash through to the dark forest. But beware of the temple guards, which may inhabit the trees. Find the key in the tree, and you'll enter the jester's court. Press yourself against the correct wall painting, and you'll gain entry to the tomb of the headless kings. Pull the binds to release their bones, and attach the missing skull to the proper king. Then race through the pit, climb through the ledges, race down the stairs and back through the temple gate. The choices are yours, and yours alone!
You guys, go ahead!
Okay, first
I'll
off...
Wait here and finally wait
I have literally nothing to say about that.
Rainbow Dash!
Okay, bye.
Hey, kid, did Apple Bloom and your friends go that way? Oh my gosh, I'm so sorry. Here. So you guys do really well. You make it all the way to the room of this.
So why are there two sweetie bells?
I'm trying to force it, but it won't go.
Did I miss something?
Try jiggling it around.
The head is backwards.
Maybe it's broken.
The head is backwards.
You get grabbed by temple guards.
They take you to the main factory where everyone is calmed down now, and they're enjoying the punch and cookies. And you don't know how that came to pass, but they do look like good cookies.
Run, Drakkarzad! Help us! How long do you think before y'all come back?
I already opened the door for you and gave you directions. What more do you want from me?
The temple guards leave you at the top of the rainbow machine, where Orion is still sitting with his puppy and stuff. Dash is cleverly taped an out-of-order sign to the operating lever of the thing, so the day
is
probably safe.
Very funny, man. I'm the factory engineer. I think I know if the machine was broken down.
You don't know. You didn't check it first. We have to close down for maintenance.
All right, boss. I know you're new, and this is hard.
Boss?
Look, I tell you what. How about we take the kid and the puppy off the machine, and we just do a practice run, okay?
Okay.
Now come over here and pull the lever, man.
Right. The lever. Which part was that again? I think I should go to the bathroom and check the manual. Really loudly.
The bathroom doesn't have locks anymore.
That's okay.
Look, I'll show you. It's not so bad, see?
Pogo the engineer clown pulls the lever. The crayons and the picture of Orion's family fall into the hole and disappear into a pit of whirring blades. After some silly noises, a stream of colorful rainbows flows out of the bottom of the machine and into a giant vat.
Did that thing just make rainbows?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's what it's supposed to do, right?
Out of crayons and a picture of a family? Are you kidding me?
I think just the crayons, though.
Yeah, I guess so.
Quick, put another picture of a kid's family on there.
We do, and sure enough, the machine produces another batch of rainbows.
I think it's just the crayons, though.
Dang. I can't believe we're going to Pony Hell for nothing!
So given the new circumstances, you guys and all the other kids go home to your families, where you're allowed to take happy pictures that are then fed into a horrible machine for the nefarious purposes of the government. Clausdale's politicians celebrate by lowering taxes for the rich. Yay, government!
Chicken memes.
So, the end.
Alright. Well.
Every week we could tell everyone.
Now bring bottle boot.
Shut up. Snake's not here, so this tank is gonna be really good.
I want to be an Oompa Loompa!
Nine!
I want to be an Oompa Loompa!
Nine!
Drakkarzad demands to be an Oompa Loompa.
Are these outtakes?
But it's just... My mom was really good at embroidering!
Then you will fail!
It's always morning somewhere. Well, that was definitely something. Okay, so, this didn't really have anything to do with Captain Hook or a gorilla. What was it? It was the biker gorilla. So, but I can guess. I'm guessing that's just, it's their code name for this. And not meant to be related to it at all. But overall, this is pretty fun. I think this might be my favorite so far. I am familiar with Rainbow Factory. I haven't read any... I might have read a few. But I don't recall reading any of the fanfics from this series. But... yeah. I don't really know if the beginning portion or anything else was at all part of this, because all I really know about Rainbow Factory is the idea that they take ponies and make them, they brutally murder them and make them into rainbows, based on like some animations and general fan canon that's been trending in the community. Don't really know what all was. I mean, that's usually the case. I don't know enough about the source material to know what all has been taken directly from the source, and then what all has been parody. Except for a couple things, I think that's the one that I was really not familiar enough to know that okay, this doesn't sound right. I think it's more of this. But yeah, this is pretty fun. We got some new characters. I don't remember their names, but you got that one cult, but mayor voice, or fitting voice. That's like, I guess, the love interest for Scootaloo here. Nothing really followed through with that except for like dialogue at the beginning, and then once everything else started, then they kind of just dropped that. So, and then you got the pony with the pony aids. Was that what that was? And the broken wing that kept falling off. So yeah, I'm not really sure what they were doing in here. I don't know if they're even in the original. Someone might tell me about that in the comments, but yeah. Overall, this is a pretty good video. Long, but it's pretty entertaining for what the series is. Voice acting was good. The hand-drawn pictures and animations, always fun to watch. And yeah. That's all I'm going to say here, so enjoy the commentary. God bless, stay safe, have a nice day, and as always, goodbye.